For those of you in the Philadelphia area, the Daily News headline says it all. Penn wins opener in the NCAA tournament. A 1-0 victory over Bucknell in the NCAA first round. Christian Barrero, golden goal, 92nd minute. Joined by the victorious head coach, Rudy Fuller, on the Rudy Fuller Show. Welcome to the show.
Thanks, Chaz. Great to be here.
Talk about, you know, we're going to start with the atmosphere. Rhodes Field was electric last night, 450 people plus, line on the sidelines, behind the goal. What was it like for you and your team to have that type of support from the student body?
It was incredible. I mean, you know, I've told people since the end of the game, I've been here 13 years and I've never seen anything like it. I mean, we really were hoping for a good crowd, and the students at Penn, you know, blew away our expectations. Not only in the sheer numbers, but the passion, the electricity, the energy, the enthusiasm. I mean, they were at it, you know, from start to finish, and really pushed the boys on. I mean, I think the team fed off of that energy, and we were obviously really happy to get the goal there early in overtime.
NCAA tournament games, there's a lot on the line. Sometimes can be a little bit of a defensive struggle there. You know, you don't want to push so hard you make a mistake that comes back to haunt you. But in this game, this match, it looked like there was a lot of ebb and flow. Penn, 12 shots, you know, it was pushing, looking for the goal there, and not just hoping to have it come to you. Was that kind of the game plan going in?
Well, I mean, we knew it was going to be a challenging game. As you and I had talked about beforehand, I mean, Bucknell's a very good team. They're a champion. I mean, they're Patriot League champions for 2 years running. And that's what you're going to get in the tournament. All the teams that make the tournament are good teams. And so you know it's going to be a challenging affair. We had a pretty good idea of what to expect, but I got to tell you, I think they were better than advertised. I mean, they're extremely well coached, organized, difficult to break down, dangerous on restarts. You know, all those things we knew going in, but they were probably a little bit better than we even anticipated. And so, you know, the first half, you're absolutely right, there was an ebb and flow to it. They had a lot of chances on restarts that we had to deal with. I kind of felt like the latter part of the first half that we started to get our feet under us and get the ball moving a little bit and had them chasing a little bit. We reinforced those ideas to our guys at halftime, and I thought the second half we were really good. I thought our guys were finding the seams and the spots and moving the ball quick and early and effectively. And we had a few chances there in the second half. We talked about it going into the game. I think, you know, coming off the Harvard game, that was one of the things that really was positive coming off the Harvard loss, was the amount of chances we created, and that kind of came to pass again in the second half against Bucknell. We weren't able to finish them, and credit goes to their goalie. I thought their goalie was really, really good on the night. But that final shot there early in the overtime finally beat them, thank goodness.
What do you say to your team in that five-minute break in between the second half and overtime? Christian Barrero, Lucas Tassagiannis have a lot of chances in the second half. Yeah. Hartman makes some big saves. Yeah. You know, so you got to kind of feel like it's coming. But, you know, how do you get them prepared to understand that, you know, this next goal, whoever scores it, it's, you know, how big it really
games
is.
Games to one. Yeah. Games to one. You know, after regulation, again, the guys felt good. They you know, the coaches were saying we felt like a goal was coming. And I think the team felt that as well. We didn't really need to tell them much. We continued to reinforce how we wanted to try and break them down, what we wanted to try and do. And again, this is a disciplined group. It's a hungry group. It's a competitive group. And, you know, with the leadership and experience we have out there right now, there's not a lot we need to do. I mean, we just need to let them play.
Talk about leadership and experience, the golden goal off the foot of Christian Barrero, his fifth of the year, but it starts from two seniors. You know, Zach Barnett, as always, on the throw-in. Yeah. Jason Gorski getting in the middle of things, mixing it up right there to deflect it to Christian. You know, what is it, you know, these guys have been there before, and how does that, you know, reflect just the overall mindset of the team?
Yeah, well, Zach Barnett is certainly one of our unsung heroes. I mean, he's been steady Eddie all year long. He's been a fantastic defender for us out wide. He obviously has the long throw, which is a good weapon for us. Guys like him and Steve Schlafer and Aaron Ross might not get the notoriety, but that's the glue to the team. Those guys, day in and day out, show up, perform well, don't expect anything in return, but they're a major reason for our success. Gorski, you know, lived up to the hype. You know, first-team All-Ivy League performer. His performance last night was one befitting a first-team Ivy League honoree. He was a man in the middle of the field, and really a lot of times was left to do it alone against some really good players in Bucknell in the air. So, you know, I think Gorski was very good, and it's fitting that he and Barnett had a hand in the goal.
For all your efforts, congratulations on the win. A trip to Maryland, national number 2 seed, yeah. ACC powerhouse, Terrapins on Sunday night at 5 o'clock. Quick turnaround for you guys. How do you prepare on, you know, Friday, Saturday practice? How to get ready for the match on Sunday?
Well, the biggest thing is getting the legs back. I mean, you know, thankfully it's not a Friday, Sunday. It's a Thursday, Sunday. So you have that extra 24 hours to kind of regenerate and get the legs back going into Sunday, which will be a challenging game. I mean, you know, Maryland's a good team. They don't need anybody to tell them that. They're loaded with talent. They've had a fantastic year, and they've been one of the hottest teams, if not the hottest team in the country, in the second half of the year. Playing at home, they're almost unbeatable. So, you know, as I said last night, there's not a lot of people around the country that give us a chance, and that's fine. I mean, I'm not sure if I was looking at the game and it was somebody else going into Maryland, I'd probably be the same way. But again, I come back to our guys. There's a lot of experience, there's a lot of pride, there's a lot of talent. And we're going to go in there and have fun and play, and at the end of 90 minutes, see where we're standing.
Well, best of luck. As always, second round of the NCAA tournament, a chance to advance to the quarterfinals for the first time in your tenure. You know, it'd be a great match on Sunday afternoon down in College Park. We hope you all can attend. Bring the atmosphere that was at Rhodes Field last night down to Maryland on Sunday. We'll talk to you after the match.
Great. Thanks, Jess.
More information on Penn Soccer, all things Penn Athletics. Be sure to check the home of the Penn Sports Network, PennAthletics.com.